Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me with wealth. I'm able to repeat my Hajj maybe even once a year. Is that better, or should I rather donate the money to feed the poor? Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ba'd. Hajj is one of the great essentials of our faith. It's one of those actions of worship that connects one to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and allows us to have a perspective of what it will be like when we return to Allah azza wa jal, in particular on the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the Hajj of those who have been and to carry those who haven't been before. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with wealth, and if your essential needs and that of your family and extended family are met, and you are able to return to Hajj, I highly recommend it. This is from the statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is authentically reported that he would recommend to the Sahaba to go Umrah after Umrah and Hajj after Hajj. Most ulama agree that had the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lived one more year and received the time for Hajj in the coming year, that he would have gone, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We see this in the precedence of his Sahaba. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu has performed 60 Hajj, one, the beginning one with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and 59 more consecutive ones. From his students and the students of the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, we hear of Sufyan ibn Uyayna, rahmatullahi alayhi wa radiallahu anhu sahabati ajma'een. He also performed 60 Hajj. And every year in his Hajj, at the day of Arafah, one of his great dua was, O Allah, return me for Hajj again next year. And his final Hajj, he did not make that dua, hoping not to exceed the precedent of the Sahabi Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma wa an as-sahabati wa tabi'ina ajma'in. So consider the importance, inshallah, of fulfilling that. But if Allah presents you an opportunity and you were set to go to Hajj, and then you found that there was someone who had a pressing need, someone who you can elevate and assist and change their life, someone who you can bless through the blessing that Allah has granted you, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهُ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, then take that precedent of the great Sahaba and the precedent of the Tabi'een, Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak. It's recorded that he had gone to Hajj numerous times, and as he is about to set forward for his Hajj, he saw that there was another person who had a great need, and he gave the wealth that he had saved for the Hajj to that person to fulfill their need. And he said to his companions, Allah has granted me my Hajj on my niyyah and has granted me the blessing of doing good to another. May Allah accept that from us. Allahumma amin.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and like the videos so that you can get notified of the new releases, and consider donating to this worthy cause.